to behave like a Suzuki parent.
So I always manage it.
Hi, very nice to see you. So you have a violin that is new, how exciting. And you have no adjusters apart from the E.
Okay.
Less exciting.
And it's a new strings too, so it's like...
ready to say goodbye to it, and the thought of carrying it back, and
Tuesday the 2nd, please come at 3 o'clock for teaching practice. Yep,
thank you.
3 p.m.
Oh, wow. Lucky you.
How do I do this?
You know, I'm just going to do it for you, and what I think you need to do, Lyla can tune her violin, but only with adjusters so far. I think what you need to do is go online and buy
some little adjusters.
An integrated tailpiece. You don't want to just buy the individual adjusters, because
why is this case so heavy?
And how does
it change
it?
I'll turn it for you.
Is there anything you can't do?
No. Apparently, play the A string.
Like this?
Yep.
Is that the right size?
Yeah. Full size?
I think so. Is that the kind of
with
price
four
that it needs to be?
Oh no, it's without. With four integrated fine tuners.
Fine, okay. And it's good.
Yeah, that one. I've put it in your basket.
Thank you.
Maybe it didn't work. The bottom one.
This one with four integrated.
Yeah.
So baba. Okay, thanks.
So baba. Okay, tonalization please. How are you going to do it?
First position.
Okay.
Because it's the easiest.
Okay. Just come this way a tiny bit and point your scroll that way a bit more. Thank you. All the way to the tip, all the way to the heel. much. So just be careful of using all of the bow. Don't be scared of this scary bit down here. It's not that scary, really. Right, so we don't have book five. Fortunately,
it's fine.
Fortunately.
How many books are there?
Ten. But I don't really use 9 and 10 because they're Mozart violin concertos and there's so many other things I'd rather my teenagers learn how to play. So many. Right, how's it been going? Do you want to play it together or do you want to just play it straight to me?
I haven't really practiced this because I forgot about it.
Oh. What?
It's the slow movement. We forgot about... Oh.
I forgot
I had to do it.
Mum's face implies that you didn't forget, you just refused to listen.
Yeah, something like that.
No, I forgot I had to do it for the lesson.
Yeah, that's what I said to you, but it doesn't matter. Okay. Next week will also be...
Okay, well let's do it next week then. Let's just do a little bit of just preparing for these big shifts. We're just gonna, if you haven't practiced it, we'll just go over how you prepare for these two, and then we'll do it next week properly. So...
The other thing I noticed, because it was very cold when it came, mm-hmm. the violin itself, and it definitely yesterday was resonating, the wood was resonating more yesterday in comparison with when it just arrived.
Yeah.
I mean, there is no, and today it sounds like it's even resonating more.
Yeah.
So,
well, also it depends how long it's been not played for.
Yeah.
You know, the wood kind of literally loosens so that it will vibrate more as it's played more. So if it's been in a cupboard for a year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, you know, it will bloom as you play it more. Good. So let's see how this one. Do you want to go through all of that again, or do you want to just play it to me and see how it is?
I'll just play it.
So good, and vibrate from the beginning of this note. Good.
Different. Same. the first one.
No, that's a semitone.
Count
the notes.
Three.
Yeah, so what? How do we call it as an interval?
I don't know.
A third?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and is it a big third or a small third?
Big
yeah,
third.
So it's a major third. Yeah? So... Sorry. Same or different? Your turn.
Different.
How many notes?
Three.
Big or small?
Small.
Is it two tones or is it a semitone? A semitone and a tone.
Semitone and a tone. Wait, no. So two is the normal ones.
There's no such thing as normal. Two. What are they called?
Tones.
So that makes it a what third?
Major third.
Yeah, so it's the same, but it's just a tone up. Yeah? Good. So. Good. Can you give me four of those? One. Well done. Light finger as you move, yeah? Good. Lovely. Three. Good. Well done. So. Diminuendo through bar 43 and 39. So at the end of each of those phrases, you're dying away, not. Which is obviously what the bow wants you to do because it's heavier here, right? So you have to go against what the weight of the bow wants you to do, and the same with the other one.
Sorry.
Diminuendo, 39.
33.
No, not 33, just 39.
Okay. Okay.
And 43.
And 43.
I said it the wrong way around.
Right. diminuendo.
Yes.
And what did you say about the bow?
That because you're coming towards the heel, you have to work against the weight, which would make it go heavier.
So you wanted to keep it light at the end?
Yes. Do you know how to spell diminuendo?
No.
Okay. Diminuendo is... D-I-M-I-N-U-E-N-D-O, and it's one word.
No, I have to write good this, otherwise I can't see it.
Okay.
I know it's one word.
Okay. Alrighty, so, I will hear it next week, please. No forgetting, stroke, confusing. Alright?
No, I forgot we had to do it in the lesson.
Yeah, and also we have a lot of things, so we were really concentrating on the third movement.
Yeah. If it's too much, we can put it off.
No.
Also, okay. We're playing country dance.
It's nice to have a lot of things, but it just means that sometimes something, you know, holds back.
Yeah. Okay, how would you like to do this? Do you want to play it together and then to me, or do you want to just play it to me, or is there a bit you need help on, or what?
I think we could do it together and then...
Do you need the music?
No.
Okay, great. It's a very hard one to remember.
We'll see.
Many memory traps, hasn't it? Should have checked your violin for tuning before we played. Sorry. Maybe they weren't brand new when you got... How long have you been playing it on it for?
Two days.
This is the third day.
Maybe they were used a little bit, which would be good.
Okay.
I do it in first position, but I think you might be putting a shift in there, which is fine. Congratulations, Lyla! Wow! Would you like a sticker?
Yes, please.
Amazing, well done. You've got all of those horrible memory traps totally under your fingers, haven't you?
There was a part where I looked at the notes yesterday and I saw that it wasn't up, and now I forgot.
Yeah. Would you like one of them?
Hot dog, please. It's a hot dog. But I don't think I would want to eat.
Do you want to put it on here,
Lyla? I want to put it. I want to put it on my sight reading book as a inspirational quote.
Motivating factor.
Yeah.
How's the sight reading going?
It's going better.
The more you do it,
the easier it gets, right?
Is it though?
Yeah. It sounds better when you do it. but you don't do it so as often as you should.
It sounds better when you do it, but you don't do it.
No, no, you do it, but just not as often as you should, probably.
Right, that was excellent. Well done. One tiny bit to have a look at. Do you want to play me from there, please? It was this bit that went a bit high, didn't it? Aren't they? But is it red?
No.
No, because what?
Because the four, no, because the one.
Is what?
Is low.
Yeah, so which one has got the two and three further away from the one than red?
Further, the two and three, that one.
Two and three have to be best friends. Look at my fingers. We're not worrying about the four.
That
yes,
one.
Well done, the purple. You've got what is called an augmented second, i.e. one, two, three semitones in there. Yeah, not just one, two, three, like in red. Yeah, so. Stretch. So slowly as you need to get this bit correct. Shift from where you were before. So if you think about which is the guide note finger?
The three. Wait, no.
It's written in your music, sweetheart.
The four.
The guide note.
A.
The guide note.
Where does it say it?
176?
Oh,
yeah. Because it's not a real note, right? It's the finger that guides you into that position, and then you put the four down when you get there. So how far has the two gone from where it was before? Where was it before? Play this slowly, just this bar. Good, and now your two needs to go to D. The two, think about the two. So how far up is it compared to where it was before? What's the interval between those two notes? Play the C.
Wait. Trying to do here.
Play me a C, please.
My brain isn't braining.
Well, yeah, buffering like we were saying yesterday. Oh, I just can't work this out. Okay, play me A, natural, B natural, C natural. Think about your natural semitones. Thank you. Right, that's C natural. D natural, play it for me with just a three. What's the distance between those two fingers?
A tone.
Very good. So you need to move your two a tone. Yeah, the shift distance is a tone. Not what you hear, not what you play. The shift, the arm distance that you have to move is one tone. Yeah? Okay. So this is the shift at the end of 175 is one tone higher into 176. Can you go from there, please? Much better. Good. Well done. Brilliant. So, if you could practice that with the guide note playing, that would be really helpful. Do you want to do a video?
Yes.
Yay.
Yes, please.
Lyla's like, oh my god, finally I can sit down. I've been standing up for half an hour. When I was a kid, we used to have to stand up.
I'll do that.
Okay. Okay. So we're talking about the top of the fourth page of the Vivaldi G minor third movement. Two on while you play D, go back to two and slide up a tone, then you can put your four on and carry on. Pull the three low. Because between this bar is one tone and you want to literally move on the two and keep it down because you're about to use it after the four. Yeah? Like that. Okay, good.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay. Would you like a credit for up to there? Or do you want to just wait until next week when you can get the last page as well?
I mean, I don't think anyone would like not want a credit for a page.
You know, sometimes people, they just want the whole thing if they're so close, but that's completely fine. Also, you're going to have to stick it home with you because you don't have your book.
If we put it here, then we can put it on the book when we come home.
Yes.
Or like if she puts it on this.
True.
Good idea.
What
do you like, a cat or a dog?
In fact, I have here a place. Perfect place.
This is very serious.
3, 2, 1.
Yes.
Up to what? Where should I put it on the book?
The first 3 pages.
Ah, okay. Lyla?
I want it to be on my finger.
Oh, you want it on your finger?
Yeah.
Amazing.
I can't
okay,
put it.
Okay, there
no,
you go.
No, no, I want to put it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good. Well done. Now. Well,
thank you.
Do you want to go through La Folia? I know your child is just marvellous. Bach double? Or,
Which one, Lyla?
Or something else?
Wait, I need to think of
La Folia, Bach double, or sight reading?
Because I found a really funny name for Shardash, which is sawdust, so I need to find one for
sawdust.
This.
Sawdust?
Yeah,
no, you had another funny name for it.
No, sawdust.
Sawdust.
Maybe it was someone else who had a not a funny name for it.
Sawdust is better.
So La Folia comes in the beginning of book 6, and we have a few students on it in the group, and then some students who are approaching it, so I've arranged it. You can have a look at what's in the real part. It's the first piece in that book. I can't give you a copy of this because it's in the other room. Anyway. Okay, let's play. Do you want me to put the colours in for you? What to say?
You can do it. Well, I did it without the colours pretty well because I can see like these things.
So then you don't want the colours?
So, yeah, we could do it at home because I already know.
Okay, cool. I'm going to put the colours in just for the beginning anyway, because it's easy to calm down too early.
That's totally why I didn't do the shit thing right when I was playing it.
It's possible.
I only did like to the end of the first page each time though. Because, yeah.
Shake before we keep going. Thank you.
My instincts.
Super quick. Do you want to shake? Are you away?
I'm good.
Okay. So make sure that you stop your bow for that line marcato. Yeah? Good. Okay. Yeah, can you just read me that? So Sarah, this is what I've arranged to be a duet with the harder parts.
Oh, I see. Right.
From the allegretto? How does the rhythm go?
Sorry.
How does the rhythm go?
How did this happen?
Yeah, well done.
I just didn't know from where I was.
Okay, good. Let's go from there. Do you want me to play the duet part?
Go on, let's see. Go on.
By using the four, then you do. If you have to string cross anyway, use an open string. Right, so what about this one?
Oh, it's a four.
Yeah, well done. What about that one?
It's also a four.
Good. This one?
It's an open D.
That's on the G string. Where's that?
Also, oh,
yeah, also for what about this one?
It's a D.
Yes, well done. So I'm just trying to catch you out there. D. Okay. Okay. Allegro moderato? More moderato. Awesome. So in group, that's what we'll say, and I don't know what Where you'll be, I can't remember, but we will work it out this afternoon. But if you're playing outside, so closest to the front, then you're going to be, or rather closer to the right hand side, then you're going to be playing these top notes which are in third position. And if you're on the inside, so you're playing the bottom part, you're like nearest to your violin hand, then you're going to stay in first position. Shall we just have a look at that bit rather than just going through this bit, which is fairly easy? I don't know what to do. And it's adagio, which means what? We're in bar 105 now.
Shouldn't do that, should I? Shouldn't drop my bow.
No, not ideally.
This was like this. This wasn't like this.
Yes, true. Okay, so adagio means what?
12-8.
Adagio means what?
I forgot what it means. The slow.
Well done. Slow. Yeah, that's it. Good. So let's play the top part together.
12-8.
We're not even doing the 12-8 bit. 1, 2, 3.
You're playing the bottom.
No, you're playing the top with me.
I want to get like a book with like lots of Ghibli music in it that I can learn.
Oh yeah, good idea.
Cause then, yeah.
Yeah, great idea.